what's going on there?
We're late to a surprise birthday party.
Oh shit. Exactly.
Nope, never had sex.
Never had sex.
I don't even know what it's like. So tell me about it.
Yeah. No, don't tell me about it. Yeah.
No, because when I was like, because
he's only ever had sex with your mom and nobody else.
Right.
Nobody
they didn't
else.
Even have sex. They
would. No, well, they
no,
did like
yes,
once.
No. Baby. When I was
three
11,
times.
Right. When I was 11. He told me, Kelly, I'm not gonna lie to you. Sex is fun.
When you were 11, parenting and children, it's an odd thing. I wish we could just be relaxed and regular with each other, like
right.
you and I are being right now.
Right.
Yeah.
But it's just, it's not a reality.
We've
for,
already got to the topic of sex, a very taboo.
Like fast, too, you
but
know.
Here we are, we're friends.
Exactly. And I don't know what that barrier is exactly, but
it's really weird.
It is weird.
I was listening to a podcast actually recently about how like you don't like the people you love most, and really like what they meant by that is like your parents mostly is like uh-huh. the people you don't get to know the most because you just assume that you know them.
Right.
But they're like your parents have totally separate lives.
Yeah.
Like they were totally.
Her mom. So we're married.
Okay.
Kelly, you said that.
Have I? Her mom told me.
Uh-huh.
We were in Arizona end of March.
Okay.
Her mom goes, oh, I made out with Ken, her father.
Right.
I made out with Ken a little bit in the hot tub. He's going to want to go on another vacation really soon.
That's why he got a fucking hot tub. They just told us today that they got a hot tub.
For sex.
They got a hot tub.
Oh, my God.
Yeah.
For sex.
That's a sex tub. Hello.
Hello. Hey, I'm just wondering, are you on the east side of the bars, or are you on the north side?
So,
no pukers?
Oh, I've had pukers, sure. Sure. But that's not even the worst thing, you know? I mean,
it's what's weird. The worst thing in your books?
I had a guy have a seizure
really?
in the front seat when I was driving to work. That was the worst, man.
You were taking him to an appointment, or just
to go to work.
Oh, really?
And he had a freaking epilepsy fit on his ride to work.
Wow.
Yeah, that was the worst, man. I hated that. I had a girl try and strangle me once with her purse.
What?
Yeah. I had an old lady pull a knife on me.
What was the strangulation about?
She was just out of her mind. And she was like, she kept like, bopping me in the shoulder, you know?
It's one of those things, no matter what she did.
Yeah, it didn't
she
matter.
Was
I was like, please don't touch me. And she's like, you molested me.
Oh,
and I was like, lady, I've never
seen. Was she the only one in here?
Yes.
That.
It was scary.
Yeah.
And I was like, I have never seen you in my life. And she says, you know what you did to me. And she put her nails, like, into my neck. And I grabbed her arm. And then she took her purse and tried to, like, throw it around my neck to, like, strangle me. So I threw her purse, you know, I grabbed her purse and threw it. And then I had enough at this point. And I pulled over and I screamed at her. And it must have scared her enough and she got out of the car. I was just like, what's going on here? Like, she was just zapped. Because I saw her get out of the car and she just laid. Like in the middle of the lawn and like wasn't moving, and I was just like, I don't even want anything more to do with this person, so
oh, damn.
I I just left. So it's like, a lot of times people are like, think the puke is like the worst thing, but I've had worse things than puke, and you know, puke you just clean up, but you got somebody like, you know, trying to strangle you. So.
Look at this fuckface.
I see him. He's doing his thing, man.
He doesn't know what the hell he's doing.
He's like, well, I'll just go out and get a drink, man.
He's like, more lonely than I am.
Well, I'm the one out driving people around.
You're making more money than we are.
Fair. But,
to be fair,
you know, the loneliness factor is there as well, man.
I feel you, man. I got broken up with over text message last week.
No way.
It was only a 3-year relationship.
Just a 3-year, no big deal.
Just 3 years, no big, you know, worthy of breaking up over text message.
So it's like, hey.
Hey, I'm done. Hey, I'm done. This is over. Oh, okay. Okay. Don't mind that I paid your rent, put clothes on your back, food on your table, and paid the rest of your bills, too, for 3 years. It's okay.
Have you seen her since then?
No. Oh, yeah, that's where I caught her cheating originally. It was Snapchat. Oh, for real? And then a girl by the name of Ash T would text her at 10 p.m. at night saying, what's up? I said, oh, who's Ash T? Oh, that's Ashley from my Tuesday class. Oh, really? I've never seen a girl say, what's up, before to another girl, you bitch. Like, fuck you.
You're right. That's not a thing, is it?
Yeah, it's not a fucking thing.
Yeah.
So I'm not stupid.
That's good. So
that was my red flag where I gave her the benefit of the doubt after that and said, oh, you're a good girl. You're a changed woman.
Yeah, sure.
So
I liked this girl like a lot in college. I really did.
Okay.
And she knows that. That's a problem.
Yeah.
She's known that for so long, and she still keeps avoiding me in a different way. And I confront her about it tonight. I actually confront her about it tonight, and then she just like went off the rails. And that's when I got in the car, and I'm like, I can't deal with this because she was talking, like, she was sitting here, I was back there, and then she was making small talk with the driver.
Yeah.
As much as she could to avoid me, she didn't want to admit that she wants me.
Basically. Okay, yeah.
Basically, but I will say one thing. I'll be strong about it. Is that the way she was coming on to me, I know for a fact what she wants. I'm gonna break it down for you.
Alright.
So, in college, she wants me. I didn't want nothing to do with her.
Okay.
Now, I want her. She wants nothing to do with me.
Right.
Things are fine. Nothing's weird. There's no weird shit between us at all. But she starts to notice that my friend's best friend's girlfriend starts talking to me, and I talk back with her and conversate, and she has this big deal about it. Without her telling me this.
To know their brother's cousin's sister's dog
Yeah.
before they even give you a phone number.
Yeah.